Why don't you tell me about your research?
You don't want to hear about my research.
Why not?
Because it kind of contradicts your research.
My dear, I have 30 years of groundbreaking data behind me, dozens of publications, grants, and a handful of global awards that are very difficult to come by. You, by all accounts, have an interesting idea. Believe me, I want to hear it.
It's a very powerful idea.
Aren't they all?
It's going to change everything.
And by change everything, you
mean... I mean it's going to change everything. The way that women think about their bodies, the way that men think about women's bodies, the way that people have sex.
Going to change the way people have sex?
Yes.
Well, don't make me beg.
In biology, every issue is understandable from two perspectives, the how and the why. In the case of female menstruation, we know the how, but we don't know the why.
You haven't yet stated a theory.
Menstruation is a defense.
Against what?
The toxicity of sperm.
My God, that's ballsy. This little theory of yours might very well make you famous, Rachel.
Not if it never gets published.
Well, there's a slot open, actually.
What?
At NORB. I just heard this morning. One of the presenters dropped out.
I just need to run it by Dean, but I think we'd both be thrilled.
But who's Dean?
My boyfriend. We were going to do it together.
Do what together?
Present my abstract at NORB.
What? You do realize it's highly unorthodox for anyone who didn't author the abstract to present it at a conference of this magnitude.
What's the big deal?
The big deal is that people will think Dean created your hypothesis, which isn't true.
Why does it matter who stands behind the podium?
All I'm asking is to give yourself a chance. You're standing right where I was with a theory in your palm that will liberate women from the shame of menses. And you're about to throw it away to keep peace in your bed. Yes, well, we weren't talking about research before. We were talking about men. Let's return to that. They're much less incendiary.